So what's the case? You know, I can't tell you, but this one could make a difference, I think. Woo-wee! That's... love that for you. Time you stamp your name on the world, Howard. It's not about my name. And the name of your partner stamps just underneath it. Tolly. Anatoly. Here we are. Gastown. Shepherd Almighty, what a swanky place. Be cool to live here, huh? Maybe if I sold my kidneys. Well, you can go on and bother folks. I'll go and get another quality Anatoly chill time. When's your truck coming? Soon, I hope. I'll be here before you know it. Bring me a magazine or a paper while you're at it. I'll see what I can do. Thanks. It's so hot, and I'm so lazy. Gastown. All right. Okay. They're in Gastown. We're hunting for this delivery of possible meat products. Wood palace? What's a wood palace? It's furniture stuff. Need a new couch, or any couch. Water 321. The liquor shop. Oh, we're going in the liquor shop. Hello. Lewis. Sorry, sir, I'm working on a delivery. Could you come back later? What kind of delivery? Please come back later. I have to close the shop. Okay. Mighty suspicious. Tuna. Hey, friend. I'm Dalton Tuna. I give you fun facts whenever you press my button. Go ahead. Press it. Do it. Eggs are very nutritious as well as a great way to decorate your home. What? Plants emit an ultrasonic sound when injured or under stress. Like they're screaming. Beavers eat a million pizzas a day. All right, let's... I just can't barge in there. The owner is watching me. All right, let's go. So buy a new pack of cigarettes, figure out where the boxes of flesh are, and help track down the fake Starling cider truck. Cigarettes. Where do I get cigarettes from? Shop. Oh, I've gone in the bookshop. Is that a monkey? Hoochie. I'm a bookseller, not a tourist guide, but we do have the Gourmand's Gallivant around Gastown if you're interested. Doesn't sound very spicy to me. Well put. Oh, you got these things with pages and words? Sir, this is a bookshop. What are you in the market for? Got any Rennie Wilson? Name rings a bell. Oh, the young fox writer. I got a book right here, yes. What's the book called? An Introduction to Systemic State Power Dynamics. Not the catchiest. How was it received? To be honest, it wasn't. Quite an achievement to get it published, and she did well not sounding hysterical, but you're about the first person to ask about it. She's young. Yeah, debut at 25 years old. Really quite unusual. She managed to get it published. That's enough about Renee. Was there something else I could help you with? Got something on the apes. Ah yes, our glorious leaders, whose treaties I am mandated to stop. Obviously, I have plentiful copies of the Ape Codex right here. I lost my copy to a fire. Yes, I heard they have a tendency to spontaneously combust. How unfortunate. Any of the apes write stuff individually? No, I suppose it's too risky for them to put forward opinions that aren't reached in quorum and triple certified. Quorum. Forgive me, but I'll take X. Three loons, if you're sure. Don't know how much money I have. Actually, I'm broke. You trying to annoy me on purpose? If so, it's working. What do you recommend? I hate it when people ask me that question. Do your own research, develop your own tastes. But aren't you the expert? Yes, forgive my outburst. I'm sure you're genuinely curious, but most folks just consume a mindless diet of cultural zeitgeist. What's been published recently? Recently, Love is in the Air and Kill Me If You Can. Oh, and a fascinating little book about the philosophy of lockpicking. What's the one on lockpicking like? It starts by explaining the fundamentals of how locks work and what we can learn about life from them. But of course it goes deeper. Ah, cool. Can I buy one of those two books? How do you pick a lock? Asking for a friend. First you need two tools, both long and thin. You start by creating some pressure on the cylinder of the lock with your first tool. Then you have to figure out which of the pins is seized and pry it with your main tool until it clicks. Repeat until all the pins are up and bingo! That was very informative, thank you. My pleasure. Will you be buying a book? Nah, I mean you've told me the good parts already. Please tell you have another book in mind. Nothing sparks joy. You're trying to annoy me on purpose. Let's move on. How long you been here? Been running this store for 12 years. Took over from my mama. Shepherd, bless her memory, if not her self-organizing system. You're going to sell books until you die? People still got an appetite for books. All my parents gave me was anxiety. Yes, well, I hardly inherited a fortune, though I'd still want to sell books if I had. I'd just have more room to sell them in. I like books. And you're easily pleased and always welcome here. Bye for now. Anything else in here? Nope. You a kitty cat of some description? Hey, can I bump some smokes off you? Yeah, I'm on my smoke break. That's fine, I'm just passing time. I want to talk. The customer's always right. Need some company? Company of a complete stranger? Wonderful. Strangers are just friends you haven't met yet. Jeez, whatever. You're not from around here, huh? Get around visiting a friend. They're not back yet. So what's up? Guess it wouldn't kill me to make a small talk once in a while. So why electrics? What are the locals like? You own this place? You own this place? Yeah, been here for a couple of years now. Hey, you've made it. All it takes is a few bad months and I'm out. Deep waters yet. I'm not out of deep waters yet. Just do your best in the present moment. The rent here is so steep, it'd be cheaper in the West End, but half the folks there don't even have a stable supply of juice. You gotta follow the loons. Yeah, but it just does my head in. I'm selling fancy new coloured light bulbs, while half the population rely on candles. Is it gonna get better? What are our worst crimes, man? Is it gonna get better? Doubt it. It is what it is. I don't know, everything seems fine to me. Keep lying to yourself. So why electrics? No, where you stand with electrics, unlike everything else in life. The electric stuff still breaks. And that's good, otherwise I'll be out of a job. You've got it all figured out. Yup. What are the locals like? They're all assholes. Why? Because they live here. I'll leave you to it. Snacks. Oh my. What a beautiful, magnificent snout, my boy. You've got a bone structure like many kinds, so it could only dream of. Thanks, I grew it myself. Of course, your kind has its own inherited problems, but I'd love to take a closer look if you don't mind. Perhaps there's a correlation. Look at what? Could you bare your teeth? Say raw. Rah. Fascinating. No sign of overbite. It's like concave curve to the canines. No yellowing at the base or the tip, but not too pale. Overbite. Overbites signify lower ethical standards, resulting in abhorrent behaviour patterns. You're not a sexual deviant, are you? Oh yes, of the utmost deviancy. There are procedures I could scribe if you'd like to fix that. No, thanks, I'm good. Now I had to ask. All in the name of jaw science, my boy. Is this like, what is it, phrenology? Is this their version of phrenology, measuring the size of your head and the distance between your eyes, that sort of bull honky? Concave curve indicates that your intellect is at a lower level than usual for faux carnivores, but not too bad. I imagine you're a creative sort. Imagine you're always such an asshole. Stop this pointless quarreling. Let us engage in science. Fuck off. Rabbits are huge in this place. Get your papers. Is that you, Bo? No, I'm Mo. Who's Bo? Rabbit from Granville? Shush, go away. You're scaring off my clients. What's happening locally? What's happening? Like what? Seen any suspicious traffic? Nope. I got better things to do than count cars. I got news to sell. Any funny locals I should watch out for? I'm funny and very local. Want to hear a joke? I'm really not in the mood. You stink. I'm joking. But also, it's kind of true, huh? Anything spooky going on? Oh man, the pigeons are getting crazy. Somebody's got to poison the bastards, I'm telling you. Or else we're going to have a geezer plague part two on our hands. That is quite spooky. At least geezers are useful. They deliver stuff. Geezers don't deserve the hate. My word, words for words, words. Never mind. Anything a lazy taxi driver would enjoy? You want news, crosswords, or a little something something for grown-ups? I thought dirty mics were illegal. It's a colouring book that suggests things in... that has suggestive things in colour. Perfectly legal. Maybe not that exciting, though. Maybe the crosswords then? Only got the ones for kiddies left. Perfect, so I'll take it. Price is one loom. Here you go. Thanks. I don't know how many looms I have. Solve a crossword. Now I want a deli shop. Can we get cigarettes from in here? Delta, who works at the deli shop. Welcome, can I interest you in some honey nut glazed apple sticks? I'm looking for some cigarettes, actually. You got any Starling cider? Sure, we got regular, red berry and pear. Expecting a delivery today? I got plenty of each in stock, why do you ask? Just curious, do you think sell anything special? What you see is what you get, it's all quality produce. I'm looking for something fresh and seasonal. Well, I did finally get my shipment of potato, tomatoes and dried onions. Finally? It's been unseasonally cold, slowed down the growth of lots of crops in the greenery. The apes are taking care of it, they say. Oh, I didn't hear about that. Right, news about suboptimal agricultural output really makes the front page. is it Ceres? We should be fine. It's just we're so reliant on the agriculture and the greenery, so fresh stuff is going to be more expensive for a while. You got red apple 6. Surely do. 3 loons for a pack of 10. Yeah, I'll take them. Here you go. That'll be 3 loons. Thanks. Thank you. Goodbye. Ocean crunchies. Good for the munchies. Doesn't look too fresh. Battling cider. This be the place. I don't know. No, I think it was that first place we went into. Oh no, was that? Oh, hello. Ah, where are we? Where's it going? Ooh. Ooh. One. Should get to that liquor shop quickly. Yes. As soon as I just check the settings. This thing seems to be a little... Let's turn... Everything just generally seems to be a bit quiet. Now the UI can be slow. Let's give that a go. And continue. Right. Oh, hello. Liquor shop. All done, Grandpa. See you next week. Do you sell, like, meats, cured meats and things? Lewis. Hello, my name's Lewis. What can I do for you on this fine, fine day? I'm looking for something to treat myself. Ah, very good, sir. Are you looking for a dark or a light liqueur, perhaps? Or perhaps that perfectly balanced something in between? What would someone likely recommend for someone like me? Ah, well, far be it from me to presume, but you seem like a man who likes to take the road less travelled. A creative type. Would I be wrong? Finally, somebody gets me. Ah, then perhaps a modern, more experimental bottle like Moro Oaked Red. Sounds delicious, but say I wanted something more exclusive. I'm quite sure I don't know what you mean. Top shelf stuff, the backroom special edition shit. I'm willing to pay big loons for less than legal goods. Something that no one else has. Maybe like you just got delivered. The rarest thing you sell. Ah, that would be the bottles of Frizz Caraldo. Apparently only 100 were made. And I have 2 bottles for sale. It's rarer than whatever just got delivered. Well, no, it just arrived, but I know what's in it. Boring old Starling cider. Nothing someone with refined tastes like you would want. What if I said it wasn't Starling cider in there? Ridiculous. I know what I ordered, but this is my shop. I won't be harangued. I won't be harangued like this in my own shop. In truth, I'm a journalist. Few questions and I'm gone, okay? Louis, I'm a private investigator. We need to talk. What? There's nothing. But if it will make you happy and leave me alone. Have you heard of Clarissa Bloodworth? I've heard of her. Who hasn't? She owns that bar, the Bite, I think it's called. You ever met her? No. Gosh, she's not the kind of person you just run into. Where were you buying those crates from? Just my usual wholesale supplier. I'd love to only sell my own brews, but sadly people are slow to love them. If they had more taste, then Then, not having money problems, are you, Louis? You stock merchandise? You selling any of your stuff to the Bight?
No, I'd love for them to stock my own brand stouts, but so far they've not taken me up on the offer.
You got any buyers for these crates?
I mean, I haven't even unpacked them. I told you, but, you know, how about a free sample of my own porter?
You're not going to get me drunk. Are you really trying to pair me off with Hooch? You're not going to get me drunk.
I like to share my own brews, that's all.
What's in the crates, Lewis? You talk or bad things will happen.
Sir, please, I don't know what you want to hear, but this shop is my life. Oh.
I want the truth and I'm ready to hurt you for it. Stop whining, you useless little man. A rational guy, Louis. This could be painless.
Talk? Talk about what? You wouldn't understand. I mean, if there was something.
When I'm impatient, I get very angry. Nobody will know. I hate Bloodworth. You'll be safe. You don't have to do this alone.
In what? Even if in my position is unique, it's not fair. You have no idea.
I really don't want to hurt you, but I will if you don't talk. Help me understand. I'm on Team Lewis. Someone... I don't know if he hates Clarissa. Help me understand. I'm on Team Lewis. Or Louis. Don't know how it's pronounced.
You'll just make things worse.
I knew what I'm doing. Lewis, I'm investigating Clarissa. I got your back.
I suppose if you found a way into the storage room after I dropped this key accidentally.
I'll take a look. Don't go anywhere. Where did you drop the key? You didn't drop the key. Oh, I just picked it up instantly. Oh, it's a bit dark. Can I put the light on, please? We've got a light switch. And raccoons see in the dark. I know wolves have got a fairly good night vision. It's a closed wooden crate. Inspected up close. Yes. There's a faded Starling cider logo on the side. The box is a simple construction of cheap wood with a flat lid. The lid doesn't appear to have a lock on it, and there is no obvious way to open it. Inspect the lid. You run your fingers carefully along each edge of the lid. At one point, there is a tiny recess in the side. Lever up the lid. With a little effort, the lid pops out from its groove. Look inside. Beneath the lid are a number of small packages, individually wrapped in thick, silvery paper. Sniff the packages. Silvery paper has a chemical tang. The rest of your olfactory observation is filled with the musty basement smells of damp and cold, old cigar smoke. Hold the puking, unwrap the package. You peel back a layer of the silver paper to reveal a neat square of flesh. There is a melange of intoxicating scents, sweet, fatty, with notes of acidic tang. Inspect the flesh. The flesh is light pink, the striated texture.
I can't fucking do this, I've seen enough.
Well, I wasn't going to get you to eat it. Alright, let's... Am I going to get jumped? Should I talk to him again? Hi, Louis.
You saw it.
Illegal fish fillets. It's a dangerous black market.
Don't you start trying to fuck with me. I really genuinely wish I could believe you. You think I don't know what fish smells like?
Some don't smell as fishy as you'd think.
When did you find out what was in the crate? Tell me everything. No one else will give you this chance.
But if she finds out I told you, I'll get thrown over the wall. You understand? If you tell us all, I'm worse than dead.
How did you end up with boxes full of flesh, Louis?
I didn't have a choice. Fate has conspired against me.
Maybe it was a hard choice, but you still had one. But did you try and fight fate? Fate is an excuse, you know that. Maybe it was a hard choice, but you still had one.
No, I did not. You'll never understand.
Calm down, Louis. Just try to explain it to me.
It's just, why me? Why her? Neither of us did anything to anyone. Just worked hard and paid our taxes. It's the damn city's fault. Why isn't her medicine free?
Someone close to you?
Ms. Bloodworth is keeping my sister alive. She pays the medical bills, even though... I even thought about selling the shop, but the loons wouldn't have lasted.
Keeping her alive, she might have already cut her up and sold her.
Leia is ill. Too ill to work. Needs medication for life, and it's expensive. The doctor's with Bloodworth. The meds are paid for, and never late.
What do you do with the boxes?
Nothing. I just look after them until they're re-delivered.
Ah. Delivery?
A woman calls, asks for the usual. I get one of my boys to deliver the crate to her. I was instructed not to ask questions.
Which boy?
Joey. He doesn't know anything, I swear.
Good for Joey. Who's the woman?
Her name is... Bajwa. It's all I can tell you, sir. I can write down the address for you. It's my head if Bloodworth hears of this.
You know this bachelor person?
I don't know. I would never ask.
My name is Howard, by the way.
Well, Howard, I don't know about you, but I need a stiff drink.
Yeah, thanks. I'll pass. I'm sorry, Louis. Where's my cursor gone? Can't move. Am I just standing here while he drinks? Yeah, what people do for money.
You're missing out, but fine by me.
Thank you, Louis. I have to go now.
Go? What are you going to do?
I'm going to find out more about this Bajwa character.
You weren't forced into this like I was. Why get involved in such nasty business? I wager you won't like where it leads you.
You do your job. I'll do mine.
Just please swear you won't tell anybody about this. I can't live in fear.
You have my word.
Thank you. Shepherd guides you.
Sure he does, like he's guided you. He doesn't give a fuck. We're on our own.
I think it's time you left, sir.
One last question. When is Bajwa expecting delivery?
Well, Joey took a crate over a few days ago. She's expecting a box of cigars today, but I'm not sure about the other crates.
Tell Joey he's got the day off. I'll take the cigars.
You can't. They'll suspect, and if it gets back to me, let...
This won't get back to you. Give me the cigar. Trust me, I do this all the time. Give me the cigars.
Fine. I can't stop you. My life might be worthless, but the people will suffer if you're not careful.
Stay safe, Louis. Take them on the house. Take them on the house. Oh, poor Louis. Right, where's your cigars? Good luck, Louis. I should call René. I didn't see a payphone in the other direction. Eh, there's the big guy. I'm Dully. I got you this. Whoa, crosswords, eh? No. What, you don't like it? No, it's just I don't even have a pen. Oh, sorry. Thanks, Howard. How's my man doing? Very good indeed. Nothing that's not shoveling baby poop. Is a top-notch good time in my book. Family life getting you down? Imagine someone small and loud tugging at your tail and craving attention all day, every day. But it's love. Worth it. Yeah, it doesn't sound like my jam. You do you, especially while you're paying me. alright, gotta go. P-phone. What was this? Hotel. The Devil Den Hotel. Not for the likes of me. Who's this? Ginger? Good afternoon, young lad. Good afternoon. How are the pigeons doing? Oh, good. Thank you for asking. They know me better than anyone by now. Better than your family? Yes, and they certainly pay me more attention. People have no sense of value for their elders anymore. Depends on the elder. Why, yes, I suppose you're right. We're all just people, aren't we? Yeah. We're all lonely together. So, you're a regular here? I come out here every day. I've done for the last 5 years. And I must say, I enjoy the peace and quiet. Are you sure you don't want some company? I don't mean to disturb you. I'll go. Big clock. Grandfather Steam watching over Gastown as always. Keep it up, old man.